Good morning, and let us go to the last article of this chapter, relation between temperature of inversion and boil temperature. Relation between temperature of inversion and boil temperature. We know that boil temperature is given by TB is equal to A divided by RB, equation number one. The temperature of inversion Ti is given by 2A divided by RB, equation number 2. The critical temperature is given by Tc is equal to 8A divided by 27 RB, equation number 3. Let us first find the relation between boil temperature and temperature of inversion. Divide equation 1 by equation 2 or equation 2 by equation 1, one and the same. Ti divided by Tb is equal to Ti is 2A divided by RB into Tb is RB divided by A. R, R get cancelled, B, B get cancelled, A, A get cancelled, and we have Ti is equal to 2 times IB, equation number 4. Meaning that the temperature of inversion of any gas is always double the boil temperature of that gas. From equation 4, we conclude that the temperature of inversion of any gas is 2 times the boil temperature of that gas. Let us have a relation between Ti and Tc. Divide equation 2 by equation 3 so that we will have Ti by Tc is equal to 2A divided by RB into 27 RB divided by 8A, R, R get cancelled, B, B get cancelled, A, A get cancelled, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8, so Ti by Tc is equal to 27 divided by 4. This is equal to 4, 6 24, 3 left, it has become 30. Again 7 4, 7 are 28, 2 left taken 0, 4, 5 are 30. Equation number 5. So theoretically, Ti by Tc is 6.75. Theoretically, we may say that temperature of inversion is equal to 6.75 times the critical temperature of that gas. That is, critical temperature is much lower as compared to temperature of inversion. Practically, equation 6 is corrected, because practical result is Ti is approximately equal to 6 times Tc, equation number 7. If we find this practically, we will get Ti is approximately equal to 6 times Tc. It means that the temperature of inversion is about 6 times more than the critical temperature. While talking about the behavior of gas at high pressure and Andrews experimentums on CO2, we talked about the critical point, which has critical temperature, critical pressure, critical value. The gas can be liquefied if and only if its temperature is held lower than the critical temperature, and then by applying the pressure alone, the gas can be liquefied. This is the result of Andrews experiment and the behavior of gases at high pressure. What about equation 7? After this, we worked Joule Thomson porous plug experiment, and we found that the important conclusion we found in porous plug experiment is that if the temperature is equal to or slightly smaller than the temperature of inversion, there is cooling of the gas. If the pressure is further increased, this cooling will liquefy the gas. Ti is 6 times more than Tc. To come from Ti to Tc, the efforts needed are 6 times more. But if we do the same thing with the Ti only, there will be a regenerative cooling of the gas. This regenerative cooling is also known as Joule-Kelvin cooling. Joule-Kelvin cooling is always preferred for liquefaction of gases over liquefaction of gases below critical temperature, because using the regenerative cooling or Joule-Kelvin cooling, gases can be liquefied particularly at very low temperature, which is about 6 times smaller than the critical temperature. And therefore, for liquefaction of the permanent gases, regenerative cooling or Joule-Kelvin cooling is used instead of liquefying the gas, keeping the temperature below critical temperature. So, regenerative cooling or Joule-Kelvin cooling is always preferred for liquefaction of gases than the critical temperature. This is about the last article of this chapter, relation between temperature of inversion and the boil temperature. In addition to that, I have taken these things for your reference, for your information. Hope you got it. Thank you.